Addictions come in many forms: alcohol, medications, gambling, sexual, and even food. This is Recovery Radio, a local radio program dedicated to helping addicts and their families. God has a plan and a purpose for your life. Here's John, Leslie, and Todd to talk about the gift of recovery on KPRZ, 1210 AM KPRZ.
Come people of the risen King, who delight to bring Him praise. Come all and tune your hearts to sing to the morning star of grace. From the shifting shadows of the earth, we will lift our eyes to Him. Where steady arms of mercy reach to guide the children in. Rejoice, rejoice, let every tongue rejoice. One heart, one voice, O Church of Christ, rejoice.
Welcome to Recovery Radio, a local radio program dedicated to discussing solutions to destructive behaviors and God's gift of recovery. Welcome to Recovery Radio. My name is John Savage, and I am a grateful recovering addict. I'm one of three members of this local radio ministry here in San Diego. Recovery Radio is a daily program that's heard every night at this time. And we talk about our newfound freedom from our old destructive ways of living. And this freedom comes from what Jesus did for you and me on the cross. In this radio ministry, and generally with us in studios, my wife Leslie, who lived on the other side of my addiction. Over the past few years since I've been in my recovery, Leslie and I have forged a much stronger bond and live today as a testimony of God's graciousness and God's goodness. And our third partner in this program is Todd Cunningham. His role is to take calls from our listeners, you that are calling in, the husband or the wife, or maybe you're an employer in town and you're watching somebody go down the wrong road of destructive behaviors. Todd enjoys putting the pieces together for you, from that initial call to walking you through the options that are out there. And he's available really any day of the week to take your telephone call, and I'll get to his number in just a moment. Over the last few months, I've shared with you my recovery journey. Everybody has their journey, and it all pretty much walks down a very dark path. Mine was of drug abuse and alcohol, living a lie, deceiving those who I love the most to keep my addiction alive. But it came to an end on May 1st of 2007, when I finally stopped trying to do it myself, but asked God to help me do it and have God do it. And I did that while I was locked up in a Tijuana jail cell. So it was May 1st, 2007, when I called to God and He heard me. And today I have a renewed purpose in my life. This radio ministry is one of those new purposes. I'm very thankful to be reunited with my family again. I'm working today, and we're here today to talk about recovery, and it is a gift from God, and we pray that you find that gift. Here's Todd's telephone number to put those pieces together to help you walk through the questions that you may have about recovery. You can pick up the phone and call Todd at area code 949-973-9140. That's area code 949-973-9140. His time is free, it's confidential, and he helps, again, put those pieces together for you. So if you're a family member looking for a solution for a loved one, give Todd a call. If you are listening to this program and you are abusing prescription medication, or you're hooked into meth, or you've got gambling issues, or food, any type of issues at all, Todd can help put those pieces together for you if you're ready to make that first step. His number again, 949-973-9140. If you'd like to send us a note, it's recoveryradiosd@gmail.com. All right, so that's cleared out of the way. All this week, we have had the folks from In His Steps up in Ramona in with us, talking about that organization and what's going on with the God's work up in the Ramona community for those who are seeking change in their life. So we welcome back Bob and Linda Denny. Thank you very much for coming in today.
All right. Well, thank you for having us this week. We are excited about what God's doing up in Ramona and at the In His Steps ministry.
What is In His Steps?
Well, In His Steps is we are residential homes for men and women that have life-controlling problems and that need a residential program that they can come in and find this oasis away from the world outside that's been holding them in this holding pattern of addiction or alcoholism and these life-controlling problems. And they can come in and find the truth, and it's the truth that's going to set them free. Yeah. It's all about Jesus Christ.
And you have a men's home and a women's home. Yeah. When people make a commitment to come into their home, they're typically beat up, but they're ready to make that change.
Well, that's what we would hope.
That's what you hope for. That's true.
that they're ready, and the greater part of them do. And they come in. Some of them are came in because their families or maybe it's the court systems have pushed them our way.
Yeah.
But, you know, and sometimes they're the ones that have a little difficulty of really surrendering. But it's like we said earlier in the week, it's all about are you ready?
Yeah.
Are you ready? Right. Are you absolutely done? And if they have that surrender in their lives, they're going to make it.
Well, you've been bringing people with you this week, and we've heard about we heard from Carol earlier in the week, and David. Mm-hmm. I think we called David number two David.
Yeah.
Yurda was here, and we have David number one.
David number one.
And I know David number one because David number one was there when I was a part of In His Steps.
Right.
Back in 07 and early 08. So why don't you introduce David number two? One to us.
David number one. All right. Well, he has now become part of the staff, and we are incredibly grateful for that. Dave was one of those gifted men, and we've talked earlier with two of our other gifted women that have that very nature of helping people come into recovery. What it takes in His Steps is somebody that has firmness and somebody that also can demonstrate love to these people, the love of Jesus mm-hmm. Christ. And I believe that Dave has that and working on that, and so we're incredibly gifted with that. And one of the things that I love about Dave is he loves the Lord.
Oh, yeah.
And he's excited about Jesus Christ. And so we're grateful that Dave's been a part of the ministry, and we've watched him come through. You know, Dave was a struggler. There were times where I remember Dave at the church one time. Is it okay to share that?
Yeah, that's so fun.
Well, Dave was at the church. And he came there so severely intoxicated that he had his vehicle on the property. And I said, "David, you get in that. You give me those keys or I'm calling the sheriffs." And so he gave me the keys. And so, but now that's been many years past. And we don't see that Dave anymore.
Dave, I remember you when I was there. How have you been?
Hi, John. I'm doing very good. And it's a pleasure to see you again.
Yeah, and, thank you.
Yeah, I'm always working on, you know, growing and in the love of the Lord and all that He has for me, you know. Mm-hmm. It's something that you have to seek diligently, mm-hmm. you know, to grow in Him every day.
Mm-hmm.
So,
well, we've had people come in this week and talk about their old person and the new person, but
yeah.
Let's talk about the old Dave and how Dave was created into the new Dave.
Okay. Well, you know, I was an alcoholic by the time I was 12 years old.
Mm-hmm.
And so through the beginning of my life, I thought that drugs and alcohol was just, that was the way of life, you know. And but I finally got saved when I was 26 years old back in 1986. That's the same year this radio station started. And I got saved, and man, the Lord just changed me. You know, I became a new person in Christ, and I was able to, the Lord just relieved me of my addiction to drugs and alcohol. And for 4 years, I was like on fire for the Lord. And then, you know, I don't even know exactly how it happened, but a string of things, but I ended up backsliding. And I started getting into crystal meth and drinking and everything else. And before I knew it, you know, I wasn't going to church. I had fallen away. Mm-hmm. And so I spent 14 years addicted to meth, everything that goes along with it. I had sexual addiction, adrenaline addiction. You know, my life, when I got saved, I had a wonderful family, a wife and 2 kids, a new car. I had my own masonry company, and I just traded every bit of it for that meth. You know, I just couldn't stop. And I was hopeless and helpless for 14 years. I tried to go to AA and NA for about 10 years. You know, it gave a little bit of relief, but I always would relapse. I'd always relapse. I mean, and it just got so hopeless and helpless, and I just didn't know what to do. I thought, you know, I just wanted it to be over. And I prayed that a few times. But, you know, one thing was those first 4 years when I was walking with the Lord, you know, I had this great desire to street preach. And I always just wanted to do that. I wanted to get like a soapbox and go on a corner and just preach, you know. And so, unfortunately, I fell away. And then I had, during that time, that 14 years, I remember this one old guy that, he was one of the first people that ever shared the gospel with me. And actually, I didn't even accept the Lord then. But he came to my place where I was, and he said that the Lord had told him to come to me. And he said that the Lord told him that he was going to use me to help thousands of people and to get thousands of people saved. And you know, he said, well, look, do you want to come with me? You live with my family. But unfortunately, you know, I had some meth in the hotel room there, and I looked at the meth. Finally, I said, you know what? Thank you, but no. Mm-hmm. And so it was still after that, it was another 8 years or so before one day I was living in Ramona, and I'd heard about this place in his steps. And I mean, I had gotten kicked out from where I was staying with a friend, and I was actually sleeping behind one of the church buildings there. And I mean, I was just a wreck. And I just barely knew that this place called In the Steps was over in this area. And I was like just staggering on the street, and I said, hey, where's that place? And some teenager showed me where it was. And I walked up there one night, and there was a bunch of men out in the lawn, and they were playing guitars and singing and stuff. And I was like, you know, I was like, I need help. And so they let me sleep on the couch that night and talked to Bob Denny the next day, and I was in. Mm-hmm. And, you know, I knew during that 14 years, you know, I prayed, oh, Lord, help me, help me. But, you know, I knew in my heart that unless I had to make the first step, but I was unable to do it somehow. I was just unable to do it. I was praying, you know, for a lightning bolt to hit me and everything would be good, but it didn't ever happen, you know. And so I went in his steps, and there they showed me so much love, and I recommitted myself to the Lord.
Yeah.
And even then, you know, I mean, I got that fire back for the Lord. And man, I did. So I was doing so great, and I was just so the joy in my heart and that peace came back, you know. And I was just like, I'm so happy. But you know what happened was about 8 months after I was there for 8 months, and I was just doing so good. And you know what? I don't even really know what happened.
You had to sabotage it.
I did. I was feeling so good. I thought maybe I could feel a little bit better with like a half a pint of vodka, you know. And and I relapsed. So I was gone for like 20 days, and I showed back up, and Bob and Linda allowed me to come back in and try it again. And unfortunately, I got there in 2004, and I guess I'm just really stubborn-headed. You know, I think the whole thing is I didn't fully give up, you know, and I didn't give my whole self to the Lord. You know, I'd give like 80%, and then somehow I'd get drawn back into that addiction, you know. It actually took me seven tries from 04 to 08. Mm-hmm. So that's 4 years. Mm-hmm. Seven tries. I came to the home three times, and then finally they said, look, you got to try something else. So then I tried another place twice, and then I finally went to that sixth place the sixth time, and I made it there for 6 months and graduated from another program. But I relapsed again, and I was just so absolutely, you know, dismayed and so hopeless and helpless. And finally, so I called Bob and Linda, and I heard that it was Linda that really wanted to give me another chance. And so thank you, Linda. I really appreciate that.
You guys give people chances.
Yeah. I'm about ready to cry here. But thank you so much. And, you know, and so I came back in the last time in May 12th of 08. Yeah. And I've been here ever since. I've made it a year in the program. And then just due to the timing, I guess, they needed another manager right at the end of my year. And I became one of the house managers. And you know, it's still... It's something that, like I was saying, you've diligently got to seek the Lord all the time. If you take your eyes off of the Lord, you're sink, just like Peter sank when he was walking on water. Mm-hmm. You know, and so I just, my life is more incredible, I've never been so fulfilled in my whole life as I am today, you know. And I've, like I said, I had everything at one time, but that's all... worldly yeah. stuff and physical stuff. And I know that the Lord is where the true peace comes from, you know, the true peace.
Bob, you know, David's talking about relapse.
Yes.
Relapse happens.
Relapse happens. It's part of the very nature. It's part of the very nature of addiction. And I know for myself, I could only put 2 weeks together at a time except for this last 25 years.
Right.
But it's just part of the nature of the beast of addiction and the hold that the enemy has on us that pulls us back into that, you know. And so it's been amazing watching Dave grow in this thing. And I watched him in those relapses. And there was a time where we said, Dave, it's that definition of insanity. Is you need to go do something else, because we were trying to do the same things expecting a different result. And so he had to go out and find some more stuff out there, and then he came back and watched him come back into an incredible place of recovery today. And you know, he not only is doing as a house manager, he's also doing the soapbox thing again.
He is
at our open door feeding program that we've been doing for 20 years. Mm-hmm. Dave is now comes in and he gives the message before they eat, and then he also does a Bible study there also. He also, there's a ministry that he's part of, is Sparrow Ministries, where they go down and they feed the homeless on Thursday nights in Presidio Park. And Dave is also now, he's on the soapbox down there preaching to the homeless. And so some of our people come from that ministry.
You know, Bob and Linda, for me, I had to get out of myself.
Yes.
And I had to start serving others. And that willingness to serve comes through that, for me, through that renewed relationship.
Absolutely.
And I saw that with David. When David was in the home when I was there, mm-hmm. I've never seen a guy that was so willing to serve. And I think that is a key for people, is the fact that how willing are you to go out and help other people's?
Yes, you've hit it on the nail, John. That's the absolute place where we're going to, where when, and Jesus calls for us to do that. It's what we've been given is to give back. Mm-hmm. And what the Word of God says is those that have been forgiven much, forgive much. And that's exactly where we're at today, is how can we not give back? And when we're doing that, we're out of ourselves. Mm-hmm. There is nothing more self-centered than a person that's in their addiction.
Oh, yeah.
It's all about me. Mm-hmm. And you know what? And it's no longer that. It's about Jesus Christ first and foremost.
Amen.
And how can I help you, brother?
Hey, Dave, thanks for coming in. It was nice seeing you.
Well, thank you, John, and it's very nice seeing you again.
All right, here comes the major plug for NS Steps. I'm going to let you guys, we're running out of time for the program. We've got a couple of minutes left, but let's talk about where you may be going with NS Steps. I mean, what are some of the new programs or new anything new going that we need to know about?
Well, you know, we did have the Cedar or the Witch Creek fire,
yeah.
And we lost the two women's homes. What we are trying to do is we're at a place where we could only rebuild one because of our insurance. Now there's a possibility, it's going to happen is the second home is we're hoping to get built here within this next year on the women's home property. We have the permits, the county's all set for us to redo this. It's just the finances that needs to come in to get this second women's home built on that property. That's one of the things. We see that growing. We also see our houses down in the Pamu Valley for the men is to continue to grow and bring in more people. And what we see for the future is more people be getting free.
Mm-hmm.
And yeah, it's so good to look in your eyes, John, and the eyes of those in recovery is freedom.
Yeah.
There is a big difference than seeing someone bound and their addiction and the hurt that causes.
Mm-hmm.
We want to see people free.
Mm.
Thank you, Lord.
Well, your ministry was instrumental for me and my family, and I appreciate what you're doing up there. And that's why I wanted to have you in this week, just to say thank you. Mm-hmm. And I think people need to know that, because there are a lot of programs that are out there to help people struggling from various destructive behaviors. Mm-hmm. But you have a very unique program up there. And it is Christ-centered, and I appreciate that. Let's give your phone number.
Okay. For the men's home, it's 760-788-4716. For the women's home, the director there is Greg Roderick, our co-founder, and that number is 760-789-5988. Mm. And we're glad to hear from you. And if we can't help you, we will refer you to someone else. But one thing that you do is when you call somebody, and I know John's going to give you a number here in a moment, is that there's help to be had.
Yeah.
And just make the calls.
It's the willingness to raise your hand and say, I need help.
Amen.
I cannot do this.
Amen. Got to start somewhere.
Yeah.
And that's a great place to be.
Well, I appreciate you coming in this week. Thank you.
Thank you, John.
Thank you very much. Well, that's our time for today. We thank you for listening. David, thank you for coming in.
Thank you.
If you need to talk to somebody and you want to raise your hand, you're ready to raise your hand and ask for help, you can do that. We have team members that you can call through Todd. Who hasn't been with us this week, but you can reach him at area code 949-973-9140. And again, he will help you put the pieces together. So when you do raise your hand and you're ready to make that change, he can help put those pieces together for you. If you'd like to send us a note, it's recoveryradiosd@gmail.com. This is Recovery Radio.
You have been listening to Recovery Radio, a local radio program about addictions and self-destructive behaviors. If you'd like a free confidential conversation about your situation, please call 949-973-9140. Help is available right now. And thanks again for listening to Recovery Radio on KPRZ, 1210 AM KPRZ.